Back to Bechtold. Jumper from the left elbow is no good. Offensive rebound to Schroff. Out to Waple. Wide open three. Left wing is good. You got a good looking stroke.
Yeah, I'm not sure how you leave that guy that wide open.
11-2. Witko on top. Brady Perez breaks the press. High on the left side for the Zebras. Got an eye. Nye between the rings. Deshaun steps into a three in the rhythm. No good. Offensive rebound to Ben Perez. Backs his way in. Throws up a shot. Blocked. Ball loose on the floor. Going to be knocked out of bounds by the Wildcats. It'll stay with the Zebras. Baseline right.
It's almost like on the Zebras' defensive end, when a shot goes up, somebody just needs to hang out with Waple. You know, regardless of whether you block him out, just don't let him get that open kickback look. That's lethal.
Rochester gets it in. Reinholdt to Deshaun, now to Brady Perez, back to Deshaun. Baseline to Ben Perez, about 15 feet away from the basket. Ball tipped around. Brady Perez, athleticism, keeps the ball alive. Give to Nye, wide open three. Left wing is good.
All five Zebra points for Jacob Nye.
11-5, Witko, 4:15 to play in the first quarter. Against the half-court trap, Waple around the defense, pushes through the center circle, and we're going to have a Witko timeout. It'll be a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Ten to play in the first quarter. Both teams have used a 30-second timeout. And after Witko's timeout, they've got the basketball going to our left. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. We're at Witko High School tonight in a conference game. First game for both teams here in the 2017 portion. West pulls up for 15 feet. No good. Another offensive rebound for the Wildcats. Waple gets it from Bechtold. Drives a baseline. Blocked from behind by Reinholdt. And his outlet pass is stolen away by Craig, he goes to the basket. Layup no good, but we're going to have a foul on the shot.
Oh, my gosh.
Is that going to be on Jordan Reinholdt?
Yeah.
Oh, good heavens. How does that cat see that 25 feet away?
Exactly. The farthest from the play makes the call.
So going to the line will be Colin Craig, a 6'1 senior for the Wildcats. 3:46 to play first quarter. Witko by six. And the first free throw by Craig is no good. Colin Corbin is. Wood comes into the game for the first time.
But once again, we've played about 4 minutes in the first quarter, and Witko has about four offensive rebounds already, and they've scored on just about every one.
Every one except for the last one.
Yep.
You're right. Second one is good by Craig, and now it's a seven-point lead for the Wildcats. And then the inbounds pass is stolen by Craig. He roses up, misses the layup, and the ball is safe from going out of bounds by Wood down to Deshaun. Deshaun pushes to our right. Wide open is nine in the left corner. He'll back it out and reset for Rochester. Now at the left elbow, outside of Reinholdt. Jordan stands with the ball above his head. Now back to Jake Nye. He'll reset the volleyball line between the rings. Out of the right side to Deshaun. Underhand pass to Wood. Back to Deshaun. 5 feet behind the arc. Back to Wood. The entry pass is taken away by Witko. Threw it into three defenders. Ahead to Craig. His layup is good. Rochester will take a 60-second timeout. Make that a 30. 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. In the first quarter, Witko out by nine now, thanks to a couple of turnovers and a few offensive rebounds, and Witko up 14-5.
Yeah, the old nemesis, you know, giving up offensive rebounds and then getting sped up and turned over,
yep.
And not just even when you turn over, but some of those quick shots, sometimes a bad shot's the first pass on the other team's fast break.
Rochester breaks the press easily. Ben Perez backs his way in against Schroff. He puts it in for two. Witko quickly up the floor. Bechtold. Throws up a tough shot, no good. And now we're going to have a foul. Is that going to be on West? I would think so. We'll wait and see.
Coming after the shot.
There will be three, yep.
Yeah. I think Bechtel drove in assuming he was going to get fouled. they kind of backed off him, and then he didn't really have any bounce, take a shot. And then, as you sometimes see in high school athletes, frustrated they missing a layup, try to make a play to get it back, and end up committing a foul.
So Brady Perez and Austin Utter in the game, back in the game for Perez. First time in for a while for Utter. Nye has it up the floor, across the timeline to Brady Perez, high on the left side for the Zebras, against a double team, out to Nye. Nye in the corner to Utter, looks into blocks to Ben Perez. Gets him in there against Schroff, loses the ball on the way up. Picked up by Bechtold. Bechtold now to Wapple. 7-point lead for Whitco with 2.5 to play in the first quarter. Whitco going to our left. In the corner to West. Fakes a shot. Drives in. Kicks it out to Wapple. Wapple, 3, left wing. Nope. Ball being tipped around. Rochester comes out of there with a defensive board. Schroff had pretty good possession, or position, too.
Yeah. Good quick release by Wapple. He didn't have the ball in his hands before it right went up.
Then Perez from 10 feet goes down. Rochester now on a 4-0 run. It's 14-9. 3 for Schroff. Nope. And the weak side rebound to West. Outside of Wapple. 3 left base or left wing is no good. Offensive rebound to Schroff to put back. Nope. And Austin Utter finally grabs the board after 3 attempts by the Wildcats. Rochester runs. 14-9. Down to Whitco. 10-footer for Utter is good again. Or good this time, I should say, for the first bucket of the game for Austin Utter. And now the Whitco lead is down to 3.
Yeah.
Down low to Schroff. He rises up, puts it over the front of the rim for 2. Full court press by the Wildcats. Nye then pushes it up the floor. This is going to say he threw it out of bounds. Not touched by Whitco. It'll stay with the Wildcats after the turnover.
Yeah, the Zebras have got 4 2-point field goals. I think they're 4 for 5 from inside the paint area, inside the arc, and 1 for about 5 from the 3-point line.
You know, Schroff, obviously 6'7". I would love to see Brady Perez go down there and just post up both Perez boys. 3 for Whitco is in and out, no good. Offensive rebound by Craig is put back as good. Another offensive board for Whitco and another 2 points because of the board. And Rochester loses it out of bounds and it'll go back to the Wildcats.
Yeah, that's about the 6th offensive rebound, and they scored on 5 of them. And then Zebras turn it over again, getting the ball in bounds.
West comes back into the game and Wapple will have a seat. Ball on the far side. Craig will look to trigger it in, and he'll get it in to Collins. Brian Collins for the Wildcat runs the point against the man-to-man defense. Outside to West, right wing behind the arc. Now to Schroff. Schroff kicks it out to West. 3, right baseline. No good. Rebound to Schroff. And he's going to be tied up with Wood, I think. Yep. And then Rochester going to get it back.
One of those games where the Zebras are going to have to make the extra effort blocking out. That was a case where Brady was okay effort, you're right in front, but these Whitco guys are coming at the boards hard. You're going to have to make an extra effort to get a body and get them pushed back, not just be in front of somebody.
So Rochester breaks the press again. Austin Utter fakes a 3, drives in the paint, loses the handle, and travels.
Maybe a little bit of a rust there. You know, hadn't seen game action in a while. I think that's when he's in, get his legs underneath him and he's in condition, he's going to make that move easily. But, you know, just coming back from injury, a little rust there.
52 seconds to play in the first quarter. Whitco up 18-11. Bechtold and Wapple back in for the Wildcats. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Coming up at halftime of this one, we're going to talk to freshman coach Joe McCarter about their pretty good start, a really good start. They're 7-1 right now, and they won a big one tonight here on the road, 53-21. West, left wing, top of the key now to Collins. Left side to Bechtold, gives to Wapple. Wapple against 9, the man-to-man defense. Takes it hard into the basket, kicks it out for a 3 to West. Nope. Offensive rebound to Craig. Over the top to Collins. Thought about a 3, gives it to Wapple. We're down to 22. Wapple backs it out of the center circle. Resets for Whitco. We're under 20 seconds to play in the first quarter.
I tell you what, as a coach, nothing more frustrating. Ice cold from 3, and you can't finish a possession and get the defensive rebound. That's just, whew.
Now we're down to 8 seconds. Wapple drifts to his left with 6. Now in the center circle. Drives it right hard with 3. Pull-up jumper from 18 is good, and that's going to do it for the first quarter. After 1, Whitco up 20-11. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Going to the second quarter here at Whitco High School with the Wildcats leading 20-11. And we talked briefly. Well, no, it wasn't briefly. That consumed most of the first quarter. Whitco up by 9. And that 9-point difference coming off of offensive glass.
Oh, easily. I mean, it's 12 points they've scored on offensive rebound putbacks, yeah, one way or another, either directly on the putback or kick out that leads to an open shot.
So West has a wide open three, left wing again. This time it's going to go. You knew, yep, he wasn't going to stay quiet for long. And he puts the Wildcats up by 2, and then Ben Perez travels before the layup. And it'll go back to Whitco, 23-11.
One of those times I think Ben may have originally thought about sizing up his steps to get a dunk down and realized he couldn't, and by that time he shuffled the feet a little too many times and traveled.
20 seconds gone to the second quarter. Waffle through the center circle, works against Reinhold, takes him to the right side. Three ball right wing for Collins is good. Good heavens. They start getting all three of them.
Yep.
And Collins is off the bench. He's not even the first one off the bench, and he's stroking it from three right now. Reinhold to Deshaun. Three right wing for the Zebras. It's in and out, no good. And the rebound fought for, and Waffle and Utter fighting for it, and we're going to have a foul on Austin Utter, so it's going to go back to Whitco.
Tough call on Utter, fighting for the loose ball, just ends up getting a piece of Waffle's arm, which may not be a bad foul either, because that was going to be a Whitco fast break, two on none, if Waffle comes up with it clean. So only Austin's first foul, team's third, probably a good foul to save a layup.
And he comes out of the game for a rest as Jake Knife checks back in. 7-10 to play, first half, 26-11, Whitco. Waffle to West, top to Collins, right side to Waffle. Waffle against Reinhold, feeds down low to Schroff, backs his way in, throws up a shot over Brady Perez, no good. Deshaun to the rebound for the Zebras. Deshaun clears to Nye. Right side of the floor for the Rochester Zebras, high on the right side, middle of the floor to Deshaun, left side to Brady Perez, feeds down low to Ben Perez. Ben to Deshaun, three straight away for the Zebras, it's good.
Deshaun's first points.
26-11. Rochester cuts the Whitco lead to 12. Schroff, right side to Collins. Now to Waffle. Waffle drives it right against Reinhold. Gives to Collins. Now to Schroff on the right wing. Over the top to Bechtold, who gives it back to Waffle. To Bechtold. Drives the left baseline. Pull-up jumper. Good defense, but an offensive putback by River West was good. Full court press again by Whitco, 28-14, Wildcats. Nye, ridden to the baseline, kicks it outside to Deshaun, back to Nye on the right wing. Nye brings it to the top of the key and resets for Rochester, swings left side to Deshaun with 2 minutes gone in the second quarter. 14-point lead for the Wildcats as Nye has it on the right wing, works against the 2-3 zone to Deshaun, left side to Brady Perez, now to left elbow to Reinhold. Jordan has his pass tipped away, and Ben Perez can't save him going out of bounds. It'll go back to Whitco.
It's one of those bounce pass goes through easy and probably an open shot. You got to make that a little extra effort on there. The other thing, too, about Zebras rebounding is, as a coach, is frustrating because they're playing man-to-man.
Yeah,
right? Sometimes in a zone you can see, you know, there's some tough assignments, but, you know, man-to-man, you're responsible for somebody. They're just not got to get those defensive boards taken care of in a hurry.
Waffle goes hard to the basket. Tough circus shot, no good, but an offensive rebound. Waffle gets it back, drives to the left elbow, kicks it outside to Swick, back quickly to Craig. Bounce pass down low to Schroff. Ugh. Rises up and puts it in for an easy two. Nice drop step, nice seal by Schroff, and got it to go.
Textbook footwork and drop step.
Yep. Rochester, Deshaun has it yet to cross the timeline to Brady Perez. Ahead to Ben Perez, crosses the timeline now to Deshaun, back to Brady Perez. Right on the left wing. Feeds down low to Ben Perez. His shot partially blocked, gets his rebound back and puts it in for two.
Nice job by Ben. Staying with it, that's what the Zebras got to do. Work the ball around that reverse and seal down in the post is open if they're patient enough and move the ball quickly enough to get there.
Yeah, you can tell that Schroff is not real excited about playing any defense. Long two-point shot, no good. Rochester shuts Whitco down, one and done. Head to Ben Perez. Right-handed layup for Ben is good. Timeout, Whitco. It is a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Pruded?
Said Pruded?
Yeah.
Beat McConaughey.
What happened there? Back at Wico High School. Well, as we were away, I think Schroff was maybe called for a travel or a three-second call, but regardless, Rochester gets the basketball back. And now Zach Deshaun dumps down to Ben Perez, high off the glass, no good, and the rebound to Schroff over the top to Collins. Wico now on the break. They have the numbers 4-on-2. Collins around the defense, works to the top of the key, outside to Swick. He'll fire a three from downtown, in and out, no good. The defensive rebound to Reinhold, ahead to Deshaun. Zach Deshaun has the ball stripped away, loses out of bounds. He's going to say last touch by the Wildcats. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left.
That is one of the things that the Zebras can take care of the boards once they've gotten defensive rebounds. There are some outlets
right there
because Whitco's crashing the board so hard. If the Zebras can get a couple boards, you got some opportunities on the other end. Got to convert, though.
And then Reinhold throws the ball away. Right in the hands of Swick. Swick against Deshaun layup. Nope. Collins put back. Nope. But there is Schroff for the rebound. And then loses it in the lane. Rochester picks it up. Right hole, middle of the floor. Coast to coast. Left-handed, right-handed layup is good. Well, Eli said in the pregame, Eli Henson, head coach of Whitco, said, we don't play helter-skelter. We're playing like that now, both teams.
Yes.
Three is no good. And another offensive rebound for Whitco.
This has got the feel of one of those games we talk about, holiday basketball.
Yeah, good call.
This looks like a game that could be played right in the middle of Christmas and New Year's.
Not a whole lot of excitement in the gym as well.
Yeah.
It does feel like a holiday.
Decent crowd, I think. It's just inconsistent basketball. There's not really a string of really good plays to get the crowd involved.
No look pass down low to Bechtold. Out to Waffle. Wide open three, left wing. Nope, off the back of the rim. And the rebound to Deshaun. Now to 9. Rochester runs to our right, down by 10. 9 stops, pops. Nope. Defensive rebound to Bechtold. Outlets to Waffle. Wico runs to our left, up by 10 with 3:20 to play in the third quarter. Wide open for West is 3. Is good. River West has 3 more. And it's back to a 13-point lead for the Wildcats. 9 ahead to Utter. Austin Utter, the right wing. Pass is tipped away, gives out to Wood, down to Deshaun, left wing. 3 for the Zebras is nope. And the ball goes out of bounds.
Yep. Zebras not getting many extra rebounding opportunities on the offensive end. Not shooting extremely well from the three-point line, but not getting any extra scoring opportunities from offensive boards. And Whitco's going to like those quick shots.
Absolutely.
Yeah, playing right into their hands at this point.
So Whitco has the basketball back, going to our left. 2:50 to play in the first half, 33-20 Wildcats. Left side to West, feeds down low to Waffle. Make that to Bechtold, out to Waffle. He drives in the paint. Down to West, top of the key. Back to Waffle, left wing. Fakes left, rolls right. Outside to West, 3, right wing. Off the back of the iron, no good. The putback by Schroff, no good. And an defensive rebound to Wood. Ahead to Deshaun. Back to Deshaun. Law pass to Brady Perez. He puts it in for 2 and a foul.
Nice job by Zach. I mean, he put it right exactly where he needed to. You know, I'm sure he would have preferred Brady dunk it, but you at least want to get the layup out of that. And Brady hung with it and gets the and one. Nice play. Great pass. Great look by Zach Deshaun. Good finish by Brady Perez. Go to the line for an and one opportunity. Foul is Robbins. His first, only the second team foul on Whitco in the half.
2:25 to play first half. Whitco up by 11, and Brady Perez at the line to try to cut this one to 10. Shot way off the mark. Schroff with the rebound. Outlets to Waffle. Waffle pushing to our left. Whitco has Southwood next week, and there's a travel. About the 7th one of the night, and the first one called.
Yeah, that's the first free throw attempt that Brady had for the Zebras of the night, and you know they've struggled here these last few games from the free throw line. You're not going to get there a bunch if you're settling for threes. It'd be nice to see the Zebras get to that line a little bit more here.
Wood, then his foul as he splits a double team. Is that going to be on West?
Going to be, I think it's on West. Yep, River West, his first, team's third.
Reinhold will look to get it in right in front of the scorer's table. Gets it into Wood. Corbin across the timeline. 2-3 zone of the Wildcats. Right side to Brady Perez. Back to Wood. Now to Reinholdt. Reinholdt back to Wood. Drives it right. Travels. Good heavens.
Got to slow down. You know, that's one of those things where I'm not sure where you're going to go on a dribble like that. But just how many? 13 turnovers. Thanks to Val for always supporting us with stats because it's not my strength.
How many offensive rebounds, Val? West, three, straight away. Back of the rim, nope. Defensive rebound to Reinholdt. Gives to Ben Perez.
Oh.
Yeah, I saw the travel, too. Or a foul.
And if he would have looked ahead, he would have saw a younger brother, Brady, all alone. He would have thrown it deep.
We've seen him throw it down already this year. No look pass to Wood in the lane. Ball's tipped away. Ball loose. Wood on the floor to get it. Ben Perez gets the loose ball and puts it in for two. Not exactly sure how that happened. But Rochester now inside 10 points. It's a 9-point game for Whitco.
And Ben in double digits.
And now we're going to have a foul as Schroff was going to the basket. He's going to be fouled on the reach in by Reinholdt. And it's going to be out of bounds to Whitco baseline right. A minute 14 to play in the first half.
Jordan Reinholdt's second foul, Zebras fourth. Like I said, Zebras, if they're patient enough, they move the ball around. They've scored at will in the paint. And they're getting really good looks. Just a matter of kind of moving the ball and making the correct pass to get it there.
Minute 14 to play, first half. Whitco up 33-24. Inbounds pass comes into Schroff. Schroff for Whitco. Works against Reinholdt. Kicks it out to Waffle and has the pass knocked out of bounds by Wood.
Must have missed a foul somewhere. The board has Jordan only having one. I have him for two. I like Jordan with one better than two myself. So
absolutely.
I'm going to defer to the board.
Waffle switches directions. Goes to the free throw line. Jump pass out to Craig. Back to Waffle behind the arc. He'll take a long three. It's nope. Good. Offensive rebound to Waffle. Leaner on the way. High off the glass. No good. Ball being tipped around. Ben Perez comes out of there with it with 50. Rochester pushes up the floor. Down by nine. With 42 seconds. Reinholdt holds. Out of Brady Perez. Back to Reinholdt, top of the key. Left side to Nye. Back to Reinholdt with 35. Wide open Ben Perez on the baseline. Back to Reinholdt. No look pass to Wood. Gives to Nye with 28. Reinholdt middle of the floor at the volleyball line with 22. Back to Nye high on the left side with 22. Now Reinholdt with 19. Jordan back to Jake Nye high on the left side with 16. One dribble to his left, Reinholdt with 12. Jordan holds with 11. Jordan directs traffic with 10. Now starts dribbling with 8. Move to his right with 6. Over the top of the defense, Brady Perez with 3. Back to Reinholdt with 2. 3 at the buzzer on the way. Nope. At halftime, Whitco leads 33-24. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI in RTC TV4. Going to the third quarter here at Whitco, the Wildcats leading 33-24, and the Zebras will start the third quarter with the basketball.
A couple of scores passed along. Winnemac girls beat Knox 41-25. Oak Hill boys 69, Peru 45. Logansport boys 35, Kokomo 21. That's a halftime score. Southwood 36, Wabash 21, halftime score. Valley 24, Northfield 22, boys halftime score as well. So we're back in the kind of normal routine now of the Friday night boys conference game.
However,
Saturday
a couple of weeks here, is going to be thrown off again because of the guy-girl doubleheader.
Yeah.
Deshaun for three off the back of the rim, no good, and the defensive rebound to Whitco. Have you seen a 17-18 schedule?
Yes, we're working on it.
Three for Whitco straight away for West is good. Will we see more of those guy-girl doubleheaders in?
As of right now, the ones we have are the ones we still have.
So North Carolina, Manchester.
Yeah, and Taylor.
Taylor's going to stay there too.
I think so, yeah. We're working on the front load of that, our first part of our schedule.
Yeah. 36-24, Whitco leads. Brady Perez for three is good from the left baseline.
Great sign. A little bit better ball movement. A couple extra passes. Good crisp passes lead to a nice look for Brady Perez for three.
Rochester stays in that man-to-man defense.
Got to take care of defensive boards here. I'm sure that was talked about.
I've got to assume, yes. Wide open look down low. Cannot be finished or is not finished by the big man, Schroff.
But
an offensive, yeah, an offensive rebound turns into a jump ball opportunity for Whitco. They'll keep possession baseline right. As Corbin Wood will come back into the game. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman, 6:54 to play. In the third quarter, Wildcats up by nine at 36-27. Wood back in to Sean out. Waffle has it to West. Three. Nope, off the back of the rim. And the rebound is tipped out. Another offensive rebound for Whitco. Waffle now has it. Feeds down low to Schroff. Backs his way over Brady Perez. Throws it up off the glass and good.
Schroff for two. He's got 10 now.
First one doubles.
No, River West now has 11.
Ben Perez can't hit it from point blank. Rebound to Whitco. Three straight away. Pull-up jumper for Waffles. No good. Another offensive rebound to Bechtold. And he throws away right into the hands of Brady Perez. To Jordan Reinholdt. His layup is good.
Jordan has four now.
38-29 Whitco.
Hanging around. Zebras are just a couple more stops. Transition, they realize and they're getting it figured out. If they can get a rebound, they can look up the floor and get some transition buckets.
Fox, West from way downtown, short. And the rebound to Reinholdt. That's one thing that Whitco has not done very well tonight that they usually do, and that's shoot at threes. Brady Perez has his pass tipped away and stolen now by Bechtold and stolen back by Jake Nye. Blocked by Schroff, and now we're going to have a foul on Schroff. Knocked Nye to the floor, and that's going to send Jacob Nye to the line to shoot two for the Zebras.
Yeah, I think he was okay. Clean block up top, and then his body took out Nye. Easy call for the official.
What are we doing? He's shooting. Out of bounds to Rochester, baseline left. Right hold to Brady Perez, three left baseline, short. Rebound to West. West through the center circle to Waffle, thought about a three. Kicks it out to West on the right wing. Back to Waffle. Drives it right hard, pull-up jumper over Reinholdt in the free throw line. No good, offensive rebound to Schroff, put back is good.
Tough angle for the shot.
Reinholdt over the top of the defense tonight. It's one thing Rochester's done well tonight. They broke that Whitco press pretty easily. Wood, almost has it stolen. Now Nye has it on the left wing. Feed down low to Ben Perez. His jumper over Schroff is good.
Had a little contact, too. No call there. Ben has 12.
40-31. Rochester down by nine. Waffle backs it out. Gives to West on the right wing. I think West waits one more second. That middle cleared open for Schroff, but he passed it up too quickly. Craig, lob pass to Schroff. He rises up, gets the basketball back, and then steals the pass back to Waffle. Nye has it now. Jacob Nye, right-handed layup is good.
Jacob Nye with seven.
And the Whitco lead is down to seven with 4:20 to play in the third quarter.
Yep, like I said, Zebras getting stops, and they're also able to score in transition. A couple more. Zebras in a man-to-man, as they have been all game long.
Waffle against Reinholdt. Gets a pick, goes to the right. Crossover dribble takes me to the left wing. Now we're going to have a reach-in foul on Jordan. That'll be number two on Reinholdt.
Nickel dimer on Jordan. Probably not one you'd really like to do because he's not going towards the basket.
Rick Hill will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4.
What Coach Henson said at the start of the game is happening. They're letting Rochester hang around.
Yeah.
Right? And Zebras kind of slowed the pace down. It's not a track meet necessarily. Like you said earlier, they're handling the pressure, the trap fairly well.
The only thing we're not doing well right now is boxing out.
Yep.
So after the timeout, Whitco with the basketball going to our right. Waffle outside to a wide open Collins. His jumper no good and a defensive rebound for the Zebras. Reinhold pushes ahead to Ben Perez. Ben Perez, right hand layup is good.
Interesting to track how many, you know, the transition scoring. I mean, most of the buckets have come in transition. Like you said, pretty simple formula. Take care of the defensive boards, and you can score easy on the other end.
West to Waple, three, left side of the floor is good. Just when you get a little run, Nate Waple rears his head.
First point since the first quarter.
Now, he's just now at 10.
Yep.
43-35, Brady Perez, three is good from the left wing. Well, if you're going to leave him alone, he might as well take it.
Brady with eight. So, like you said, like to see Brady in that double figure range definitely tonight and consistently down the stretch.
Collins, he'll fire another three on the right wing, in and out, no good. Offensive rebound to Schroff. And then Schroff is going to be fouled on the reach in by the Zebras.
Zebras have switched a little stronger. Brady Perez guarding Schroff down low, trying to body him up, keep him off the boards. He's done most of the damage. That foul is going to be on Corbin Wood, his first, team's second.
Baseline left of the Wildcats. Waple, step away, 15-footer is no good. And the rebound to Rochester. And Schroff was on the floor with his right, holding his right hip. Oh, you can't do that, can you?
Well,
you can't stop. Rochester's on offense, and you can't stop. They stop the game, the officials do, to check out Schroff.
He's trying to say you can only stop it if there's a fast break.
What are you saying?
So when there's a tentative, if you have an attack in the normal flow of the pace of attacking the basket, it goes. But as soon as the play was kind of stopped, halted a little bit, referees can make that call and stop play.
Yes. So Deshaun comes back in.
I've never seen it like that way.
Nor have I. And if that happens again tomorrow or the next day, we may not see it again. Who knows? Yeah. Under three to play in the third. Whitco up 43-38. 2-3 zone for Whitco. They've been in that all night. I don't think they came out of that 2-3 zone.
No, yeah. Zebras played half-court man, and when they played half-court defense, Whitco's been in the 2-3 zone.
Brady Perez, a long three off the backboard, supporting out of bounds, and go back to Wildcats. Yep.
He's knocked out a couple. Maybe a little bit of a heat check. Zebras get back to finding the seams of that zone, pass cutting, moving.
Well, that'd have been a big shot.
Yeah, sure.
Cut it to two.
Yeah.
Waple to West. Dribbles to a couple times to his left. Three left wing for Robbins is off the back of the rim and through. And now the lead is back to eight for Whitco. Quickly up the floor of the Zebras. Nye left wing, Brady Perez, three left baseline. Nope. And an offensive rebound for the Zebras. Deshaun put back, no. And Waple has it. Now we're going to have a foul coming on Deshaun, I believe.
Yeah, another one of those frustration fouls. Zach did a nice job of getting that offensive rebound, but he kind of threw it back up there. He didn't have good position to take a good shot. Should have probably kicked that back out and reset the offense.
So Schroff comes back in the game, and coming out is Craig. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman.
Looked like they were working on Schroff's hip over there on the sidelines.
Coming up tomorrow night, Rochester girls basketball against Whitco. They're fair this year.
Yeah, not bad.
West on the wing, gives to Collins, looks down low to Schroff, now has the Waple. Waple drives it left, kicks it out to West. West at the free throw line, to a wide open Collins. Robbins, his three is good. Make that Robbins. Alex Robbins has his second consecutive three, and it's 49-38, back to an 11-point lead for the Wildcats. Baseline move to Ben Perez, blocked from behind by Schroff, and Schroff is going to pick up the foul of the body, and Ben Perez will go to the line to shoot two.
Fouls on Schroff, his second. Team second. Yeah, we've seen this a little bit. Like we said, Brady's shot could have cut it to three. You know, miss a couple shots at one end, give a couple buckets, all of a sudden it blooms to 11.
We need to hit freebies, that's for sure. And the first one is no good by for Ben Perez.
It's only the Zebras' second free throw attempt of the night. Brady has the other one. That was also a miss.
Ben will have one more. Looking to cut this lead to 10. Nope. And the rebound to Schroff. Now he's got to be approaching a double-double.
Oof. Easy.
Bechtel to Schroff. Right side to West. West against Wood. Dribbles out to Robbins. Left side to Collins. Down low to Schroff. Block from behind. Got some skin on the block, and that's going to send Schroff to the line to shoot two.
Which Jordan Reinholdt picked up his third foul, team's fourth. He said Schroff's going to go to the line to shoot two in the act of shooting. He's got 12 points on the night. Easy. He's got to have 10 rebounds by now. I think he had about six at half. So.
I think he had six offensive rebounds at halftime.
Yeah.
First for Schroff is no good. Wapple gets a quick rest, and he's back in the game.
Not a lot of free throws. I mean, Zebra shot one in the first half. Witko shot four.
I think first half ended with both teams with two fouls.
Yep.
Schroff's second one is good this time, 50-38. Biggest lead of the game has been 14 for the Wildcats. 120 to play in the third quarter. Rochester the basketball. Deshaun against the 2-3 zone. Left side to Wood. Back to Deshaun, left wing. High on the right side to Reinholdt. Back to Deshaun. Baseline to Wood. Corbin Wood rises up from 10 feet and gets it to go.
Corbin's first bucket of the game.
Rochester cuts the lead to 10. 60 seconds to play in the third. Wapple, right side to Robbins. Top of the key to Collins, left side to Wapple. Just inside the arc. Jumper on the way is no good. Offensive rebound for Witko. They lose it out of bounds.
Zebra's fortunate to get that one back as Ben Perez is down in front of the Witko fans on the other side. Didn't see what happened.
He's face down. Now he turns over, still down. I think it's an elbow. And he'll get helped up by Austin Utter, and he'll be replaced by Jake Nye.
Wholesale substitutions for both teams. A couple line changes.
Yeah. Bechtold comes back in for the Wildcats. 49 seconds to play in the third. Witko up by 10.
Thought the Zebras might maybe attempt to take the last shot. I mean, get a two or three here, score at the end of the quarter, get some momentum heading into the fourth.
Yeah, I think that's a great idea. And now we're going to have a foul down low, I believe, on Craig. I think it's a good call.
Yep. Got his arm wrapped around Utters. He's trying to make the pass. Craig's first. Team's third.
43 seconds to play in the third quarter. Witko up 50-40. Rochester basketball out of bounds right in front of their own bench going to our left. Wood hands off to Nye. Under 40 to play in the third. Back to Wood on left wing. Nye top of the key with 32. Now to Deshaun. In the corner to Brady Perez. Brady looks back door to Wood. Can't find him, but there's Utter on the baseline. Over the top to Nye. Nye, 3 for 22 is no good. And the rebound to Witko. And now we're going to have a foul on Deshaun.
Deshaun gets caught reaching in the cookie jar there.
Yep.
Great play by Corbin Rudd. Made great effort to keep the ball alive. Just couldn't deflect it to a Zebra player.
West back in, and Beck told to come out. 19.6 to play in the third. Witko by 10.
Coach Reinholdt, a little pressure just so kind of give Witko a different look as they're going to try to get the last shot of the quarter now.
West across the timeline against Brady Perez. Man-to-man defense by the Zebras. Wapple holds it now in the center circle with 10. Wapple holds with 7. Dribbles to his right with 6. Accelerates around Wood with 3. Gives him the corner to Collins. No good. The put back at the buzzer, no good. And that'll do it for the third quarter. After 3, Rochester down by 10 to Witko. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI at RTC TV 4. Fourth and final quarter we go here at Witko, and the Zebras will start the fourth period of the basketball and down by 10 at 50-40. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Rochester lucky to be within two or three possessions here.
Yeah, I I think they're very fortunate to be here. Getting a couple more stops and scores here. They're right where they want to be. I mean,
Reinhold kicks it out to Nye behind the arc on the right wing, and he travels.
Not what they needed, obviously. But, yeah, good, it was a good sign, though. Zebras were moving the ball. They were trying to get a good look. Like I said, you're only down 10 with 8 minutes to go. You've got time to kind of be patient on offense, but you got to avoid the turnover bugaboo while you're doing that.
Yep. Just hold Whitco to one here for about a three-minute stretch.
Yep.
If they shoot, let them shoot, and they missed, rebound and go.
Yep.
West high on the right side. It's Reinhold. Law pass to Schroff. Ugh. Wide open layup is good.
Yep. Just no rotation from the weak side over there on Schroff. He's got 15. Lead all scorers.
Brady did a good, pretty good job trying to jump that pass and play in front of him, but nobody, like you said, came to help from behind. Nye on the left wing. A minute gone in the ball game. A minute gone in the fourth quarter, I should say. Zach Deshaun for three off the back of the rim. No good. And ball being tipped around. Whitco comes out of there with it. And now Reinhold is down. Jordan is down, holding his face. Whitco wasn't in a fast break, apparently, and they stopped play. So Jordan is still down.
That's interesting. Referee basically said, you got the benefit of the call down at the other end when Schroff was down here.
Yeah,
that's basically his explanation. He said, you got the call down there, and we stopped it for your guy, so we're going to stop it for their guy. Even though that was a fast break attempt going the other way. And now,
well, we're going to take a 30-second timeout. Jordan is still down. You're listening to Zebra Basketball 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Minute gone to the final quarter. The Wildcats leading 52-40. And Jordan is being attended to.
Looks like
I wonder if there's some blood on him because the big man Schroff just went to the locker room to change jerseys.
Yeah, Schroff's going to have to get a new jersey. He's got blood on his. Looks like they're kind of looking at Jordan's eye, maybe cut under the eye.
Yeah.
Trainer's putting on gloves. Usually a sign blood is present.
Well, and I see it.
You're turning away.
I got enough issues tonight. Wample from 18 feet is short. And Rochester, one and done.
In a good way.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Keeping Whitco to one and done. That's got to have more of that here the last 6.5 minutes.
2-3 zone by the Wildcats. 6.5 to play. Nyan gives the baseline to Brady Perez. His pass picked off by West. West behind his back dribble. Right side of the floor. West goes coast to coast. He lays it up. It's good and a foul.
Yep. Jake Knight thought about the charge, but as we've always said, you cannot react and get a charge call. You have to anticipate to get in position for a charge call. Jake thought about it a little too late. He's going to pick up a foul and give Weston and one opportunity. Only Jake's first foul, Zebra's sixth. So Whitco will be shooting free throws the rest of the way. Zebra is taking a full timeout.
It's a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. To play. And the basketball game, Wildcats up by 14, 54-40, which I believe is the biggest lead of the game for the Wildcats. Yep. Shroff is back on the floor wearing 31 now.
So, yeah, for those of you keeping score at home, Spence Shroff is 31 in your program.
Yeah.
As Wes makes the free throw for the N1 opportunity.
55-40. Witko up by 15.
Shroff now has 14 himself. Three in doubles for Witko.
That was my next question.
Surprisingly enough, the last of the three and the least of the three.
Wapple
with 10. Only 3 points since the first quarter, which is also frustrating the Zebras. You're holding him down, but still down 15.
Yep. 6 minutes to play. Nice splits of defense. Leaner in the lane is good.
Nice drive by Jake Nye, knocking on the doorstep with double figures. He's got 9.
How many doubles for Rochester?
Right now, just Ben Perez with 14. Brady's got 8, and Nye's got 9.
West and left baseline, dribbles to the wing now. Turns right side to Wapple. 3 over Wood. Yepper.
Just like that, he's got 13.
58-42. The lead is 16 now for Witko. Wood outside to Nye. Nye on the drive is fouled, and I believe it'll be out of bounds to Rochester baseline right.
Foul's going to be on River West. His second, team's fourth.
I don't suppose West or Wapple will foul out anytime soon, will they?
No. Wapple has no fouls. And
what'd you see there, Tony?
He's just got a little cut under his eye.
Must be the right eye, huh?
That was left.
Okay.
I'm walking in.
Utter over the top. Gets it into Nye. To Wood. Pass is tipped away and stolen by Shroff. Shroff, left side of the floor. Goes to the basket. Out of control. Offensive rebound. West is fouled on the way back up. Or it'll be on the floor. Wait and see.
I think we're going to throw something. I mean, they're going to shoot free throws, but we'll give them 2 or it'll be an and one. Foul's going to be on Ben Perez, his second. Team 7.
It will be a 2. Ugh.
Uh-huh. Threw that thing up at the end of the play and got rewarded with 2 shots.
And the rebound, or the free throw for West is good. At 59-42, 5:13 to play in the game. Would go up here, looking to push this lead to 18 with a freebie from West, and it's good again.
I know Wapple gets a lot of the headliners, but I'm really impressed with West.
Yeah.
I mean, that three-headed trio of those two and Shroff inside.
Utter's reverse layup goes down.
Utter with 4.
You know who I just noticed hasn't played yet tonight? I don't even think he's here. The floater in the lane by West is good again. Liam Leininger's not even here tonight.
Was not at school today.
Oh,
maybe sick, yeah. Okay. Battling some illness.
9 for 3, left wing. Nope. And the rebound to Shroff. Over the top of the defense to Bechtold. 4-0 break. Wapple travels, no call. Layup, nope. Gets his own rebound back, and he's fouled before the putback. That's going to send Wapple to the line for 1 of the bonus with 4:38 to play in the game.
Yeah, River West has 18 points at this point. Wapple has 13 going to line, looking to add to that. Jordan Reinholdt checks back in. So whatever eye issue he has is not preventing him from playing.
Yeah. So at the line will be Wapple for 1 of the bonus.
First time to line tonight.
First one for the senior is good.
Fouls on Wood, his second.
Foxel or West will be back. Shroff will be back. Second one is good again for Wapple. Really good guard play in the conference this year.
Oh, yeah. No kidding.
20-point lead.
Still got a lot of good ones to see, too, on schedule.
Yeah, you're right. Really good.
Boys and girls. You look at the conference. Yeah, boys and girls.
Well, we're going to see a pretty good one tomorrow night.
Yeah.
And then Rochester will take a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC-TV4. back at Whitco High School. Whitco by 20 here late in the game, 4:24 to play. You know, finishing that comment, I know we'll talk a lot about this tomorrow night, but you got Allie Reif, right?
Yeah, Allie Reif. Right. Six-foot point guard from Whitco going to Xavier.
And then the following weekend, you've got a six-foot whatever she wants to play, and Seacrest going to Yorktown. That's two D1s. Youngstown. That's serious.
Yeah, and I would think you'd see Seacrest probably play more on the wing in college rather than as a post at that size at that D1 level.
Yeah.
Yeah, really good guard play. Really good, strong conference, both boys and girls this year.
Shrove travels. He's got to be a travel, doesn't it? What are we doing? Now we're going to have a tie-up. Shrove slid about 10 feet. No call of a foul, no call of travel. Now we're going to have a tie-up. Coach Henson wanted a timeout. We'll wait and see what the call is going to be.
That's one of those things where you can kind of slide on the floor as long as you don't have possession of the ball.
And that's exactly what they were saying.
Yeah, yeah. So in theory, you could slide 25 feet, but as long as you don't have possession of the ball and you're even as you're bobbling it, that's okay.
Yeah.
Which I've always thought weird, but.
That reminds me of that picture there for a long, long time in NBC Sports and Shaq when he's sliding along the, coming down the lane, sliding about 15, 20 feet. It looked like he had possession, but apparently he was bobbling too. So Whitco keeps possession on the tie-up. Waple around the defense, kicks it out to West. West on the wing, gives back to Waple. He'll fire a three from downtown. It's good again.
Yeah, Zebra offense has kind of went cold here in the fourth, and Whitco has kind of heated up. Zebras only have 4 points here in the first half of this quarter.
So Nye has it and throws it out of bounds.
In the meantime, Whitco's outscoring them 17-4 here in this first 4 minutes of the quarter. Hasn't really been turnovers. Zebras aren't turning the ball over, but the offense has been very efficient for Whitco.
Very true. I agree with that. Three and a half to play in the game. Whitco up 67-44. Waple from Shrove. Ugh. Again, I think he's going to start to heat up.
He's got 11 in this quarter now. 21 for the game all of a sudden.
Shot's good and a foul in the lane by 9. He'll go to the line to shoot one.
Foul's going to be on Shrove, his third. Team's fifth. Jacob Nye gets it to fall. Jacob Nye now in doubles with 11. Chance to add free throw here to make it 12.
Collins make that. Robbins comes back into the game and Bechtold sets down.
Yeah. Walpole had 10 going into the fourth quarter. Seven of those came in the first quarter. He's got 11 now in the fourth. Can there be a quiet 21?
I think we're seeing it. Nice free throw is good. Averaging 29, so he's well below his average. But there's 3 minutes to go in the game.
Yeah.
He keeps shooting like that. He keeps getting looks like that. And Jordan Reinholt steals the basketball to Brady Perez. Back to Reinholt. Left-handed layup is good.
Jordan with six.
West to Waple. Little man-to-man pressure in the backcourt. Waple clears out Shrove and crosses the timeline, and now we're going to have a Whitco timeout. It will be a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI and RTC TV4. Two ticks under three to play in the game. Whitco up 70-49. And after the Wildcat timeout, they have the basketball going to our right.
Yeah, they've outscored the Zebras 20-9 here in the fourth quarter. So it didn't seem like all that long ago when Brady Perez had a chance to cut it to three.
Yeah,
and,
you're right.
Here we are chasing 21 now.
Well, at that point, it was, 38-43.
Right.
And Whitco began to heat up. Waple way downtown and wide open. Good again. He's approaching his average of 29, I believe. He's at 24.
24. That's his 4-3 of this quarter.
Nye high on the right side to Brady Perez. 2.5 to play in the game. 73-49. Whitco, and the entry pass is taken away by the Wildcats. Craig outside to Waple. Waple through the center circle against Reinholt. Around defense. Pass outside to West. Three left wing. Ugh. No, 76-49. Whitco.
West has 21.
Wood kicks it out to Reinholt. Three left baseline. Nope. Defensive rebound for the Wildcats and Waple. Ahead to on the drive. Waple's fouled at the basket. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
Probably going to get Corbin Wood, I think, on that one, although Jordan had some contact too, but I think Wood got it first. No, they are going to call it on Jordan.
Huh.
Jordan's fourth. Team's ninth. Waple's going to line for two.
Okay. Minute 57 to play in the game. Waple at the line for two freebies. Here at Whitco High School. First one on the way for the seniors. Good as it rolls around and falls through.
You know, this is one of those examples as he has 28, averaging 29 for the season, where sometimes scores just got to stay patient, right? He had seven early in the first quarter, didn't score in the second, got a three in the third, but just scores sometimes got to let the game come to them. I don't think he's forced anything, had some good looks, couldn't fall, but if you play the game the right way and you're a scorer, the game usually comes back to you. And, you know, the teammates did a good job finding him, and, you know, here he is knocking on the door of his average. He's got 28 points.
Waple makes the next free throw, and he'll come out with 29.
Yep.
78-49, Whitco, and they've pulled the starters. Have the Wildcats. Well, no, I take that back. Bechtold is still in the game.
Yep.
Minute 50. Jordan Reinhold over the top. Pass tip right to the hands of Nye. Nye on the right wing. Out to Deshaun. Drives it left hard to Zach. To Brady Perez. Brady Perez on the left wing. Dribbles now top of the key to Nye with a minute 35. Jake Nye stops. Pops. Nope. Air ball. Gets the Ben Perez gets the loose ball and puts it back in for two.
Ben Perez with 16 to lead the Zebras.
And Rochester going to clear the bench as well.
Nice up and under move. Nice up and under move by Tim Ginch.
And he has fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two with a minute 15 to play in the basketball game. And Reinhold has just fouled out.
Yep. Jordan's going to foul out with 6 points. 2 points in the second, third, and fourth quarters each.
Carter Hooks in. Jacob Good in. Alex Onofield in.
I believe this is Jake Good's varsity debut.
I think you're right.
Onofield and Hooks have been in before.
Ben Perez, good game.
Yeah, solid game from Ben Perez with 16 points.
Free throw by the big man is no good. He'll have one more.
Guessing a little used reserve, Mr. Ginch, because as he got in the game, the crowd erupted, and
yeah,
as he almost scored, they got even louder.
Free throw is no good, 0 for 2. Brady Perez rises up, grabs the board out to Nye. Micah Tan will come into the next opportunity for Rochester. Brady Perez from way downtown. Nope. Another one and done for Rochester. Nope. Alex Onofield gets the strip by Nye. He puts it in for two.
First varsity points, I think, of his career.
The teardrop shot by Whitco is no good, and Good with the rebound. 50 seconds. Well, Whitco is going to improve to 6-5 overall and 2-1 of the TRC. Ginch gets the outlet pass to Bechtold and pulls it out with 38. Three on the way for Whitco is way off the mark. Hooks with the rebound. Hooks dribbles away from trouble with 30. Rochester going to slip to 0-8 overall and 0-3 in the TRC. Jake Nye picks his way through traffic and lays it in for two. 20 seconds.
14 points for Nye.
Near side. To Swick. The shot by the big man is no good. We're going to have a three-second shot. No good. Blocked twice. Picked up by Good with three. With two. The back of the lead of the trail official not even moving. Shot at the buzzer at half court is no good. Final 78-55. Post-game show coming up next, 92.1 WROI.